Hi, let's have a talk about the cardiovascular system. The cardiovascular system has four parts to it. There's the blood, the heart, the blood vessels or the vasculature, and the lymphatic system. The cardiovascular system could be mapped throughout the body. You can follow the pathway of the vessels from the heart out to serve all of the metabolically active tissues throughout the body. The blood is our vehicle where we're able to transport nutrients, gases, waste products, hormones, etc. to these tissues. And there's going to be exchange between the cardiovascular system and its contents and the interstitial tissues and fluids that surround metabolically active tissues. So the blood really is the vehicle for materials to flow by means of the heart through the vasculature. It transports materials. It also helps to regulate acid-base homeostasis, temperature. It serves a protective function in terms of it being a host to the immune system. And it also helps to regulate clotting. And there are two major constituents to the blood. There's the plasma, which is largely water, and the formed elements, such as these erythrocytes and leukocytes and thrombocytes. The heart is the pump of the cardiovascular system. It is comprised of cardiac muscle tissue, surrounded and invested by connective tissue, that sits within the thoracic cavity, specifically within a segment of the thoracic cavity called the mediastinum, and it is ever working. From early on in development until the day that you die, and perhaps even beyond if you're an organ donor, the heart is going to beat in concert with our metabolic need for oxygen and other nutrients. The vasculature, or the blood vessels, are the pathways by which blood moves from the heart out to the metabolically active tissues, returns back to the heart, and then goes out to the lungs, and then returns back to the heart, and then goes out to the metabolically active tissues, and so on and so forth. The main constituents of the vasculature are the arteries, which are vessels that deliver blood away from the heart, and veins, which deliver blood back to the heart. And nestled between the arteries and the veins are the capillary beds, which are the site of nutrient and gas and other material exchange between the cardiovascular system and the interstitial tissue. Lymphatics are, in all fairness, a system unto themselves. So people will frequently refer to the lymphatics as the lymphatic system. But they can just as easily be seen as a subset of the cardiovascular system. The function of the lymphatic system is varied and will be explored in subsequent lessons. But for the most part, the role of the lymphatic system is to reclaim filtered plasma that was lost in the interstitial tissue and not resorbed back into the cardiovascular system to prevent edema or swelling. The lymphatic system is also notable because it transports fatty acids and lipid-soluble vitamins from regions of the small intestine back up into blood supply. And finally, the lymphatic system is a sizable host to our immune system and helps us to modulate immune responses. So we've talked a little bit about the cardiovascular system, its constituents, and their functions, and we'll explore these topics in greater detail in subsequent lessons. Thank you.